All right, they say this one is not running. I just went inside. The fan is actually running and blowing air, but I hear nothing out here, so I'm going to open her up and see. Just get, oh, now she's running. Let's see. Thermostat was already on calling when I got here, so we're going, and now it turns off. Aha. Uh-huh. So don't run too long. And it's a 410 system, so I'm going to have to get my other gauges to be able to see what the pressure's doing. Maybe a TXV or something like that, and high pressure's kicking in, or the low pressure's kicking in because it's low on charge. So let me get my gauges and see. Like high pressure is definitely kicking out. So let's see if we can figure out flipping into heat mode and see if it actually runs that way or not. Well, I have taken the top off, and because it don't matter if I put it in heat or cool, the high side goes 500-600 just like you saw, and then the pressure kicks out. But I know somebody else has been here before me. Who, I don't know, but we have evidence. Somebody came here because there's a cleaning brush right here. So I have no idea who left their brush here. But for some reason, the high side definitely kicks in every time. Wire it up, at least get the fan wired back up. There we go. Capacitor. All right, now it's time to take the nitrogen out. And what I like to do is when I drop the nitrogen out on a package unit, if any way possible, take the drain line and actually blow it out. Well, it's time to get a hose. Started to do a vacuum, and this one wasn't sealing, and I found out why. The rubber sealing there was all corroded and everything, and so I pulled it out, and I got to get another one to replace that in there. The hose is fine. It's just, it was not sealing. So I put the cap back on here, and I'm just pulling out one side. And should be good. Probably take a little longer, but get this fixed and get that hose back on there. Trying to beat this sun. Got here early this morning. When I got here, the sun was right where the grass is not cut. It was about halfway, and it's got itself all the way to here now. But I'm still in the shade. Get a good vacuum on this thing and put the 111 ounces of gas back in it. Turn it on. Alright, I hadn't got all the gas back in there quite yet. It's supposed to take 111 ounces, which is just short of 7 pounds. And I got six pounds and 3 ounces in there, and I turned it on. That's 6 pounds and 3 ounces all that would go in there before I turned it on. And now I'm letting it run, and that looks a lot better. It stays where it should be. It's not going up to 500 or 600 PSI on the high side anymore. All right, let's top off the gas, finish putting it back in, and we're going to the next one.